Today, we're talking about the new neural filters introduced in the fall 2021 version of Adobe Photoshop 2022. Coming up, we have the Harmonize, the Landscape Mixer, neural filters. When compositing a subject into a background like this, things like color tones and brightness will need to match. You can use various adjustment layers to do this, but why not let the new harmonization neural filter do it? So I have a subject here, and I had already cut the subject out of the background. It was on a white background shot in a studio, and I worked a little bit on the mask already, and I put this subject in this background right here. So here the subject needs to match the environment. This background has all these colorful leaves. All those warm tones are going to be spilling all over the place, all over the subject, all over the road. And so we have to have this subject blend in to this background. So the first thing I want to do is make a smart object out of this layer where the subject is. So I'm going to convert this to a smart object. And you have this little icon right here on the layer. If you double click it, you can actually go back into the smart object and you have the layer mask still there if you want to work on it. And you just close it and it'll ask you if you want to save. So one thing you want to make sure of, the layer that you're going to use to blend in to the background, you want that layer to either have a mask or transparency. So now if I go up here to filter, neural filters, and I'm going to highlight harmonization, and I've already downloaded all the filters here. This is a beta filter and it had a download button on it. So you need to do that before you use it. So I'm going to turn on the filter, and now you have to select a background layer. So you're going to have to choose which one you want to be the layer that's going to affect your subject. There's only one here. So I'm going to click on that, and Photoshop is matching the color and the luminosity. So that was pretty quick. And down here, you can click to show the original. You can see that the subject was a lot brighter. Photoshop tried to blend the image in to the background. But this is just a starting point. So now I can come here to the strength. If I think this is too much, I can back that strength off. And here's before and after. So it's not as strong. If I think it's still too saturated, I can bring down the saturation a little bit. And maybe it's a little too bright still. So bring down the brightness. There's the before and there's the after. So now the harmonization neural filter got us pretty much to where we wanted to get. We can take this out of the neural filters and do more to the image. So down here, we have all these output options. If you choose smart filter and say, okay, this is what happens. If I expand this over here, you see that it is now a smart filter. So I can go back in to neural filters, specifically to the harmonization. So I'll click on that and I can go in and make changes and have it go out to my smart filter again. If I turn off my filter, you see there's the before and there's the after. And you can still add adjustment layers to this to refine it any way you want. You can work on the mask again, but instead of creating, say, a levels and you're working on it and it's affecting everything, you'd have to clip it to the layers below, make your adjustments. But instead of having all those adjustment layers up here, why not combine them all together with the smart filters? So I'll get rid of this and I'll come up here to image, adjustments, levels. So when you add levels this way, it is part of the smart filter, and any adjustments you make are just affecting the subject. And that way you don't have to make a clipping mask or you have other adjustment layers on top of that. You can keep on adding adjustments, image adjustments. Say you want a vibrance, you can adjust that, see how that looks. You can keep on adding adjustments. You want a curves adjustment layer, you can make minor adjustments here, and they're all part of the smart filter. And so you can go back into any of these adjustments and adjust them again. You can go back into the neural filter. You can adjust that again if you like. So this is a good way to use the harmonization neural filter as your starting point, but it gets you part of the way there without going through some of the other methods that may take you a little bit longer. If you're getting value out of this so far, hit that like button and consider subscribing. So now I have a landscape photo open. I'm going to make this a smart object, and I'm going to go into filter, neural filters. This time I'm going to choose the landscape mixer. I'm going to turn on the landscape mixer, and you have all these presets here that you can click on and see if you like the effect. Some may be too strong. You may like it, but you don't like it as strong. You can use the strength. You can go through all these and see which ones you like, if any. Oh, that one looks pretty good. If you don't like any of the presets here, you can reset it up here. It says reset parameters and click on where it says custom. It says select an image, and I'm going to select an image from my computer, and I just happen to have one right here. It says use this image, and Photoshop goes to work, and boy, it really made that look like a desert. And you can use any of these sliders down here along with the presets or the custom photos that you have. And let's say if I want to make this sunset, so see, I can use that in conjunction. Can add summer, can reset this, and I can go for complete winter, something like that. So that's just with the slider, and I'll reset that again, and I'm going to go for this winter one right there. I like that one. Was one of my favorites. It did pretty good there. And of course, you can output as a smart filter and go back in and change it. Just double click on the neural filter, smart filter, and go back in and change it to anything you like. So I have another landscape example I want to show you that's pretty interesting. This example here, of course, I'm going to make it a smart object and go back into filter, neural filters. I'm going to choose my landscape mixer, switch it on. And I think I want to go for something like this. Yeah, something like this, just to show you. Now, see what happened was the landscape mixer affected the subject. So whenever you have a subject in your photo, there's something here called preserve subject. So if I click on that, the landscape mixer did not affect the subject. I can also harmonize that subject. So if I click here, that helps blend in the subject with everything else. So now you know whenever you have a subject in your photo, you can preserve it and not have the landscape mixer overtake your subject. And don't forget, you can use your strength adjustment to take this down a little bit. So here's something that you could do. If you don't want the sky to be this colorful, what you can do is come up here, and there is a subtract from selection and an add to selection. So if I click on subtract from selection, and I'm going to come up here and say select sky, and click the invert button. So see, my sky is selected right now, and I'm going to output this to a smart filter. So now I get my brush, B for the brush tool, and paint with white on my layer mask right here on the smart filter layer mask. And I'm going to paint with a low flow, and I can paint in as much of this sky as I want to with a soft brush. So I can build up my colors just the right amount that I want to. And so you have the ability to mask out areas. This might be helpful, like to make it believable. There may be some issue with the feet. Luckily, the feet down here are in the sand. You may need to mask some of that out and paint in some shadow. Here I was able to mask out the sky completely because I didn't want that strong color in it. And so I could paint in just the amount that I wanted to. So that was the landscape mixer. If you want to know more about Photoshop, click or tap on one of the videos on the screen now. If you haven't already, subscribe, like, and share this video. And remember, it's never too late to learn. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.